Sun is starting to go down pretty quick. I still got about 20 minutes before I even get out here to the woods. I hate setting up at dark, but that might be what I have to do.
I'll have to keep it small. I miscalculated kind of where I wanted my stove. I knew I wanted my stove about an arm's length away from me while I'm in my cot, but I didn't realize it was going to be so low to the ground. So I propped it up as much as I could in the back. You know, I pulled the tent up, and then I poked my legs down in the ground. Next time I come out, I'm going to cut these legs off to where they're only about 3 inches long instead of 12 inches long. And that'll lower it. And I'll still be able to feed it, you know, while I'm laying down, but it won't be so close to the tent. But my stove jack, I don't know if you can tell, I think it's gonna work. We shall see that. I'm getting hungry though. It's time to cook. Maybe I won't start cooking yet. I need to relax. I've been working hard ever since I got here. It's not supposed to be about work. It's very windy out here though. I gotta keep my fire small. Both of them. Yeah, that one's still doing good. Got my campfire going. I just want some coals on here and a little bit of light, you know, so I can cook my chili. Cheers.
He's already cooked. Jalapenos, bacon, cream cheese stuffed bacon wrapped jalapenos. That I cooked yesterday. I'm gonna chop one of these up and put it in my chili. Maybe two. Oh yeah.
gonna eat this chili and then I'm gonna go to bed.
Well, my chili was good, real good, but I only could eat about half of it. It's supposed to get down to freezing tonight, so I guess it'll be all right until the morning. I'm just gonna wrap it up in a towel and put it over there. I'll eat it for breakfast, I guess. Anyway, it's 10 o'clock. I'm tired. And might as well go to bed. There's my DIY dark matter custom made pipe. My big old bushcraft pipe. Like double. I can load that thing up and smoke on it all night long. Thanks again, Dark. It's very cool. And anyway, see y'all in the morning.
It's good stuff. As usual, I learned a couple things. One, the first thing is my ammo can stove is too small to sustain a fire for more than 30 or 40 minutes. And it takes constant feeding, you know, maintenance. You gotta move stuff around. It doesn't really heat up. It heats up like 2 or 3 feet right around there for a little while. But I think it's more for, you know, for this tent, which is not built to even retain heat, I don't guess. I either need a bigger stove or insulate this better. That's one thing. Two, my Coleman Lantern. Wow, what a game changer that is, man. It's not as loud. I've camped with some people that you hear this roar, like the whole, that one hardly makes any noise at all. It's a 1965 model, and I rebuilt it, and it works great. And I woke up several times during the night because coyotes were howling like crazy, but about 4:25 I woke up and it was out. So it went from 5:30 last night till 4:30. But that thing lit up my whole camp, and I like that. And then thirdly, again, I'm a hammock guy. I just can't. I slept warm because I had my mummy bag inside my big quilted bag, and they even had a wool blanket on bottom of that. But still, it's not as comfortable as a hammock. It's cool though because I don't get to do this very much. This open air kind of camping with no nets or nothing, but. It got down to like 34 degrees, and there's no bugs out here. There's a couple little granddaddy long-leg spiders that keep getting in here, but they don't hurt you. And I guess that's all. I do want to say thanks, Doug. Appreciate you hanging out with me and camping, cooking some chili. Hey, this chili's even better this morning. Anyway. See y'all next time. Bye.